Now we want to organize our code in separate functions. In order to improve our code, we should be writing input and output functions. This input code will be shifted in a separate function, and over here we shall write the call for that input function. Input function, it is the responsibility of input function to get date value from user and return that date value into the main program so that it could be assigned to D1 date1 type variable. Date type variable D1. Similarly, we want to write an output function. So both these cout statements for displaying date1 and date2 will be removed from the main programs, and these will be replaced by the output function call. Output function will get data from the main program. So data of both dates should be passed into the output function from this part of the code, from main program via its argument list. So D1 is the argument of output in the first call, and D2 is being passed to the output function in the second call of this output function. We have written the function calls of our intended functions, and now we should write the definitions of the input and output functions so that our program will produce exactly the same output. Before writing the definition, you may first write the prototypes of these functions. From these function calls, from the input function call, you can see what we have thought, the name of the function within the input. And the argument list is empty, so we have written an empty argument list. But in the function call, you can see on the left side of input function, we have assignment operator, and we are assigning a return value data returned by the input function to D1 variable. What type of data should be returned by the input function? It depends upon the data type of this D1. We will see the declaration of this D1 variable. What is the data type of D1? What we have written over here? It is date type. So, date type value should be returned by the input function so that it could be assigned to D1 date type variable. So, the return type of input function will be there. Now we want to write the prototype of output function. You can see in the sample function calls, on the left side of output there is nothing, no code, nothing written on the left side of the output function call. So return type can be void. We are not using the value returned by the output function, so we do not need to return anything. Return type of output function is void, name of the output function is output, and from these function calls you can see what type of data is being passed in both these calls. What is the data type of D1 and D2? Both of them are of date type. Variable names does not matter. They can be A, B, X, Y, any variable name, but their data type is the programmer defined structure, which is date structure. So the output function will take one date type value as argument. So prototypes of input and output functions are complete, and now we want to write the definitions of these input and output functions after this main program. Output function, you can write input or output function. First, their sequence does not matter. You can write either input or output, any of those functions first. Why? I am writing output function first. I am defining output function first. Output function requires one date type value as argument. When the day passed from the main program, it can be D1, it can be D2, or it can be some other date type variable. And now, in the cout statement, I should be using this variable name with the dot operator in order to access the attributes of date type, date structure. A dot day, again in the same hyphen format, A dot month, A dot year, and end of line. Output function is complete. It does not need to return anything. The same code is returned which was previously written in main program with the slight modification in the variable name, because instead of using, you can use D1 over here. Okay? Then this line will be exactly same as we have written previously in the 0 one here. After the input function, output function, we can write input function. So the input function is basically after the output function, and the input function should return a date type value, not what, but a date type value. We can create a local variable, you can name it as ABC or any symbol, suitable symbol, with the message enter date and the CN command, exactly the same format, A dot day, A dot month, A dot year. And one additional thing, that this function should return in the date type variable A. This return statement would not have been possible if day, month and years are scattered variables. We cannot return three integer values. But if these variables have been combined, collected in one date type variable, we can return that one date type variable as return type of this input function into the main program, so that the date value given by the user in the input function will be assigned to the D1 variable of date type in the main program, and which will be later on passed to the output function so that it could be displayed back to the user. So the same simple function for demonstrating input and output functionality, but slightly improved variation of the code. We have now created input and output functions, and we have called those functions in our main program, and the output of this program will be exactly same. The output will be same. There will be slight changes in the memory structure, because now we have local variable A in the output function, and we also have a local variable A in the input function. So these variables will also be created in the memory, but the output will remain exactly same if user enters the same date. I hope this organization of code is understandable. Any part is confusing? You may note it down, and if you want to